This video is sponsored by Squarespace. Ahoy, this is Zdenka. I've been in the photography business for many years. I've seen lots and I've done lots. I'm very fortunate to be able to do this full time. Photography, now video, YouTube, teaching. There are things I've done for my business okay. There are things I've done really well to be able to grow successfully. Looking at my past, there are definitely things I would have done a little bit differently to grow my business even faster. You don't need to be a struggling artist. In today's video, I want to share my strategies which worked for me for past 15 years and strategies I've seen in action and worked very well. My only regret is that I didn't do them myself. I've met many photographers over the years, photographers which were humble, they worked very hard, they were treating the clients with respect, and the quality of work built their name and reputation. I've met photographers which were average and below average. They were not afraid to sell, even if it went to the point to upsell, even if it went to the point to push for hidden charges, even if it went to the point to include photos in their portfolios which were not their own, only to get the clients. Even if they knew that the photos the client will get is not gonna be what they are showing in the portfolio. Where do I belong? I'm the one who was always telling myself that my photos are never good enough. And that was working against me lots because I was always putting all my time and all my efforts into my work, my portfolio, and I was not putting enough time and effort into my business and marketing. My clients must have the photos they dreamed about. They must be absolutely happy wanting to show it off to all the friends. I might not be shy in the camera now, but I was always a little bit shy around people I didn't know, strangers. I was always the one making all the excuses in the world not to go to a big party. I am from a smaller city, but I'm close enough to Toronto. I have a background in modeling, so what I knew is how to pose, work in front of the camera, and I had an extremely strong advantage over male photographers. I'm a female. I also knew many local models. Naturally, what I started to do is contact one by one, building my portfolio and also theirs. I did tons of free shoots. It took some time and eventually the photos I created started bringing me actual clients and as models were showing off my work to other people. Because I'm a female with extensive background in modeling, I felt very comfortable posing other females and that was attracting a lot of glamour makeovers clients and also modeling type of clients. I did advertise here and there as well. It is part of any business, really. My website was bringing me many clients, but the rest was word of mouth. What was very important is that what the clients saw in my portfolio, that's what they were taking from the photo shoots, the same results, nothing less. Many photographers are making mistake right there. They have over the top high-end photos in their portfolio, which they show to the clients, but then the clients at the end is not getting the same quality of the photos, is not getting the same results. The photos need to be consistent in order to have the clients advertise for you. Above all this, making the clients comfortable, making them feel special and welcomed, being very friendly, all that counts. The client will talk about you a lot. Your personality will help you sell, but your personality is not gonna sell you at all. What can really make you stand out in 2021 is a special skill. I know a videographer, which is also a figure skater. You may have seen me post some posts about him on social media because he was covering the world's figure skating championship. Jordan Cohen, skating with a camera on a gimbal, getting some incredible footage on ice. Not too many people can do that. That's a special skill right there. That's a guarantee for him to stand out from the crowd. Now the question is, if by any chance you don't have some type of a special skill which can make you stand out from the crowd. Weddings and event photography is hard. The hours are long and sometimes it might be physically challenging and mentally as well, but they are absolute gold for your business. Let me explain. I know it's 2021 and right now it's very slow with the weddings and events, but once this whole thing is over behind us, I have a pretty strong feeling that there will be a large spike when it comes to weddings especially, and maybe events as well. I'd be ready. Why are they gold? You are meeting huge amount of people. What I absolutely suck at is approaching strangers to talk to the strangers. So I was hiding behind the camera most of the time. But when it came to giving the final photos to the bride and groom, all I had to do is share their online portfolio, well, send them the link to online portfolio and say, feel free to share it with your friends and family. My website address was right there. And when people visited my website address, they saw that I am also doing glamour shoots and I'm doing makeovers, that I'm doing family shoots and portraits and all the other stuff. And I got many extra bookings from those weddings. Speaking of websites, thank you very much Squarespace for sponsoring today's video. Squarespace is the all-in-one platform to build a beautiful online presence and run your business. I've been using Squarespace for almost a year now, and the experience is excellent. All I have to do is choose one of their award-winning templates, which you can fully customize, choose a domain name, and you are set. If you need help, they have 24/7 customer service. They have all the tools you need. You can link all the social media there and display it directly on the first page like I do. One of the features I really like as a photographer is their portfolio and galleries, which are pre-designed. You can choose the look you like. You can also create password protected pages just for your clients. Another feature I also like is blogging tools. It is very easy to write a blog, add photos and videos, and schedule it to be published at a later date. Lastly, appointment scheduling is also available. To make it much easier for your clients to see your availability, book or reschedule if needed. Head to squarespace.com for a free trial. And when you are ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/Zdenka to save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. If you watch my channel for a long time, then you must have met Jamie Espinoza in one of my past videos. Photographer, the second shooter at the weddings, working with me side by side for a number of years. The reason I picked him, because he is a role model, even though he doesn't think of himself that way, when it comes to events, making the most out of them and marketing himself the right way. He offered himself at all kinds of events, sports, music, politics, photographed models, did so many free shoots, every time showing off his work on his website, making contacts with people. People started noticing him and calling him. His website looks really impressive and full of work he can do. This is the best way of doing it. His work ethics were unbelievable. Sometimes I had to actually stop him. You know, go sit down, have something to eat, relax, because I knew that with the amount of photos he's gonna give me, I'm gonna be editing for days. I don't remember exactly how many years we were working together, but he grew over the years so much. Last few weddings, when I was editing the photos, I actually, when it comes to the candid ceremony photos, I had no clue sometimes whose photos were whose. I was like, look at the file numbers to see it. We had such a similar style, and this was a true extension. We worked together so well. We were complementing each other very well. I've tried roughly 30 photographers over the years, and most of them only really shot one wedding with me. Drinking problems, sitting by the bar, not really working. Or some of them delivered 200 to 300 raw photos after a 12-hour day, or their photos looked nothing like the photos they showed me in their portfolio. The quality wasn't there. I don't settle on okay. Toronto is very highly competitive. I was booking 25 to 30 weddings a year. I asked Jamie if he would be willing to share with you the most important things to do when you're just starting out. So this is what he wrote me. Number one is research. Do as much research when you can. This will help you make informed decisions that range from the basic decisions. For example, what camera settings to shoot with, to the significant decisions. For example, what camera body to invest in. Number two is practice. For new photographers, practicing will expose you to new scenarios, and TFP arrangements are a good way to learn. For experienced photographers, practicing will help you retain and refine your skills for important jobs. Number three, self-awareness. Assess your skills and personality to find your strengths and weaknesses. This will help you identify your comfort zone in your photography and business. Number four is marketing. Determine who your target market is and the best way to reach them. And last one, patience. It takes time to find your style, build your portfolio, and book clients. Be realistic with your goals and continue to adjust them accordingly. Oh, and this one is huge. Something I didn't do and I should have done, my biggest regret, because I didn't know enough about marketing at that time. There is this very big wedding company in Toronto, which asked me if I could help them to shoot a wedding. They needed a help. And I said, why not? I had nothing to do, extra cash. Well, they have a very large staff of photographers and videographers. They are always booked solid for the year. One extremely smart thing they did was to use one of their staff photographers to take portraits of families and couples at the wedding. And they had a nice setup. They put a background, they put a studio lighting and all that. The photos were very nice, good quality. What they did, they printed the photo on the spot, had it nicely framed. Of course, there was their website address and contact information, and they placed it on the tables for all the guests to take home. So when the guests displayed the photo somewhere in the house and then somebody asked them, who was the wedding photographer or videographer? Do you know anybody? Oh, sure. Yeah, we were just at this wedding. This is the company. I failed at this. Huge. Most of the weddings have 200 to 500 guests. That's a huge marketing. Most of the people were afraid to give few things. I was one of them. I wanted to get paid for my work. This simple thing could have just changed my business completely. I could have hired more shooters and it could have just grow and grow and grow. What I would highly suggest to pick something like that, depending on what type of photography video you're doing, a small free gift which can reach a very large audience. So you don't have to necessarily rely on bridal networks and advertisements or brides and grooms recommendations only. I've used a lot of social media over the past years too, but personal recommendation from a friend doesn't beat that. I actually didn't get many clients from social media. Most of it was honestly word of mouth. All that works together with passive income, selling products, stock and all that, you could be on the way of making 100k a year. I don't shoot weddings anymore due to my eye condition. I cannot work with flashes anymore, but I'm very happy to share my knowledge and everything I learned with those who will use it the right way. Best of luck to you.